Hello and welcome to the course Advanced Computer Network. This is the lecture 1 of module 5. In this lecture, we will introduce the internet security concept. Particularly, we are going to discuss about IP security. There will be a series of lectures on IP security, and this is the first one which describes the operations mode used by your IP security. So let's begin. So generally, the internet security can be applied on three layers. That is network layer, transport layer, and application layer. The network security, when it is applied on network layer, that technique is called IP security or IPsec. In the series of discussion of regarding the IPsec, what we are going to cover, let us discuss it. We will first discuss two modes of IPsec, that is your transport mode and the tunnel mode. Then we will discuss about the different protocols. There will be two different versions of protocol used by your IPsec, that is called AH, stands for authentication header, and second one is called ESP, that is called encapsulating security payload. Then after this, all these discussions, we will talk about security association. What is that? A technique that changes the connectionless service of the network layer to a connection-oriented service for the purpose of applying security measure. If you remember the technique of network layer, we have already talked that IP is a connection, provides connectionless service. That means whenever a sender wants to send a data from the send the data to a receiver, then that packet will be traveled throughout the network with different routers connected in between them, isn't it? So then it will reach to the destination or the receiver. So whenever data transferred from source to destination, that provides a connectionless service. But whenever the data gets connectionless, then applying security is difficult. That's why to make the security feasible, if I want to implement the security features to this communication, then we need to make the entire connectionless service to a connection-oriented service. That is called the security association concept. We will talk about that. Finally, we will check the application of IP security, that is called virtual private network. But still, this is not in your course. The things which are written in a green color, that is transport mode, tunnel mode, AH, ESP, security association, all are included in your course. But VPN is not included. If time permit, I will complete the VPN part also. And if I am completing the VPN part, then there will be obviously the question, there will be chances of getting a question inside the examination. If I am not able to cover this, then no question will be appear in the examination. So let's go forward. We will start talking about IPsec. So where we are now? So the network layer means we are talking about network layer security. So as I have already told you, in a network layer security, the concept is called IPsec. So let us talk about that. At network layer, security can be applied between two hosts, two router, a host and a router. Right? These three way it is possible. To provide the security at the network layer, IETF. So what is IETF? That is Internet Engineering Task Force. Designed a set of protocol known as IP security, or it is represented as IPsec. The IPsec operates in two different modes. So as I have already told you that we are going to discuss the two modes of operation of IPsec, that let us start that one. So there are two modes. One is called transport mode and second one is called tunnel mode. So what is a transport mode? The transport mode, the IPsec protects what is delivered from the transport layer to the network layer. If you know that when the data get transmitted, the data first transfer from, or the packet get transferred from transport layer to the network layer. So if I want to protect the data that is traveled from your transport layer to the network layer, then we will use the transport mode of IPsec, right? That means transport mode protects the payload. Payload means the data to be encapsulated in the network layer. Check the figure over here. let's say transport layer want to send this packet. So that is the payload he want to send. Now he want to protect it. So if I will apply the IPsec technique in transport mode, then what will be happen? In between transport layer and the network layer, there will be another layer, it will be introduced, that is called IPsec layer. What is the work of this IPsec layer? The payload which has been generated by your transport layer will be added with header and tailor of IP security layer. Then this IP, the entire packet which is now becomes the payload for your IP, will be transferred to the network layer. Network layer will protect this, means it will put an encapsulation on it, and now the entire packet will be treated as a IP payload. He will add the header. We know that header will consist of the source address, destination address, and there are many fields others will be discussed. You know what are the fields of IP header packet. So the network layer will add the header, and the packet will be encapsulated, which is come from your transport layer. Then this entire part will be called your IP payload, right? But that payload is actually encapsulated or has been protected by your IP security layer. Fine. So next point we want to discuss over here is transport mode does not protect the IP header. So as IP security layer is only apply its technique on the payload which is transferred from your transport layer, so the IP header is not protected. That means IP header is not encapsulated by the help of your IP security layer. So transport mode does not protect the whole IP packet. So this is the IP packet which are going to be sent from the sender to the receiver. So in transport mode, the whole IP packet is not protected. Rather, it protects the payload only. It protects only the packet from the transport layer, that is your IP layer payload. Now it is acting as an IP layer payload. So that data which are coming from your transport layer, that is protected. But the entire IP packet is not protected in transport mode. This mode is used when we need host-to-host protection. So if you want to apply the host-to-host protection, then this transport mode is used. Now I'll take a bigger picture to show you how the things are working on a particular internet architecture. So this is the bigger picture. If you see this picture, this is a node who want to communicate with this node. We know that in a network layer, this communication is called node-to-node communication will be provided by your network layer. So this is I am showing the node-to-node delivery of packets. This node is connected to a switch. Switch is again connected to some routers, and the connection you can easily see. Maybe the data transferred with this path, maybe, but does not matter which path it will follow to transfer the data. But there will be a logical connection between the sender and the receiver according to your network layer. That is your node-to-node delivery. So if I want to apply that security measure on transport mode, then this logical technique has to be taken care of. Logical connection need to be came into your mind. Now see what happened. So in this particular node, you will have all the five layers: application, transport, network, tunneling, and physical layer. Now the transport layer will generate the payload, as I have already discussed this one in the previous class. In the previous slide, so this payload will be encapsulated by your IPsec header and IPsec tailor to this payload. This payload is again encapsulated by your IP payload. Okay, then IP header will be attached. You can see the security has not been provided on the entire IP packet. It is only provided to the payload which is generated from the transport layer. So this packet is transferred to your destination host. On receiving the packet at the destination host, the IP payload will be transferred to the network layer. The network layer will decapsulate it and find out the destination address. So header will obviously, according to the IP header, the packet will be delivered over here. Then it will be decapsulated to find out the payload. Then payload will be transferred to your transport layer. Then the remaining application, which is the application which is running on this server, will get this value, right? This is how the transport mode works. Now the next one is your tunnel mode. So as I have already discussed, in your transport mode, only the payload get protected, but the entire IP packet is not protected. So that problem is eradicated by the help of a tunnel mode. So what is the tunnel mode? The IPsec protect the entire IP packet. In case of tunnel mode, the IPsec will protect the entire IP packet. It is the advantage over your transport mode. Now how it is done? That is shown in this figure. You can see here the network layer will generate the packet. We don't think about the payload which is generated from your transport layer. Now this payload has already been there inside your IP packet. This is your IP payload. Now the IP payload will be attached with IP header. So IP header has been attached. Now this entire packet will be again transferred to the IP security layer. So in the previous mode, if you check about the transport mode, the security layer, the IPsec layer, is in between the transport and network layer. So this here it is present. Okay, so payload will be transferred to the IPsec layer, then IPsec layer send the data to network layer. But in this case, you can see that there will be no, the IP security layer is not present in between your transport layer and the network layer. It is actually present after the network layer. Means the data will be actually present in the network layer itself. The IP security layer may be the part of the data network layer. So first of all, whatever payload I get from the transport layer, it will be attached with IP header, and now it is termed as your IP packet. This IP, the IP entire packet will be transferred to your IPsec layer, IP security layer. He will attach the tailor and header to that entire packet. Now, after attaching this actual header, which is provided by your network layer, is also protected by this IPsec layer. Now it is protected. So after this protection, it will be inserted into your new IP payload. So the new IP payload will be attached to this, and a new IP header has been attached to this. That means in this particular case, the entire IP packet, this is actually the IP packet, this is the new IP packet, but this is the older IP packet, and actual data is present over here. So the entire IP packet is encapsulated, or that means protected by your IP security layer. Okay, now this data will be transferred to your data link layer, and it will be transferred through the channel. Fine. So it takes an IP packet including the header, applies the IP security method to the entire packet, and then adds a new IP header, as we have already discussed. Fine. Normally, this tunnel mode is applied. Normally, it is used between two routers. Router means, if you see this figure, it can be applied on this two router. It can be applied on a host and a router, and a router and a host. So if we are trying to protect our packet in tunnel mode, so these features can be added. And if you think about transport mode, in transport mode, only host to host transport mode, only host to host security can be applied. Okay, that is the difference between tunnel mode and your transport mode. That's all about the mode of IP security. We will discuss the next protocol in the next class. Thanks for watching.